Hi guys, welcome to Bream Time. On this channel I show you underwater footage of my bream fishing sessions. Today I want to show you what happened a few days ago. Check this out. Head underwater, falling back into you. I thought we'd be smarter. I got nothing left to lose. You said you'd fall with me. This turned out to be one of the most frustrating sessions of the entire season. My plan was to fish at close range and fish a pop-up buoy from the source. I've tried it earlier and it worked really well. Even though I know that this is a great bait, on some days some baits just don't work. And this turned out to be one of those days. My worry at this point was that they just couldn't see the boilie because it's kind of a natural colored boilie. After 40 minutes standing over them, just watching them swim around and not pick up the bait, I had to change something, so I went for a white pop-up boilie. For that reason, I decided to pick something that would really stand out that they just couldn't miss. But as you can see yourself, I forgot to check the rig. I've used this rig lots of times over the summer for different kinds of pop-ups and it's never caused me any problems, but for some reason this boilie was much more buoyant so it wouldn't go to the bottom. This was entirely unintentional. One advantage with fishing at close range is that you can really see what's going on. When I fish at close range, I'm not always using a feeder because sometimes it's just easier to loose feed to put some boilies, some pellets, some corn over the bait. I know it's not easy, I know we could dive into. We're not like the others, they do not need to. When I lose feed at close range, I really have two options. Either I put the bait on the inside or the outside of the pre-baited area. Advantage with fishing the outside is that the fish tend to come from deeper waters, so that's where they start picking the bait. So you tend to get an earlier strike if you're fishing in that area. Well, that didn't work neither, so at this point I went to my go-to bait, corn, because I pre-bait with corn but rarely use it on the hook. So if I'm desperate, that's what I'm using. Head underwater, falling back into you. I thought we'd be smarter. I got nothing left to lose. You said you'd fall with me. No matter how far it goes, down deep and under. On the other hand, if you suspect that the fish is cautious, you want to fish on the inside so they get used to whatever you're presenting to them. Again and again, I could never let you go. Something about you feels so different. Makes me wanna risk it. Every time I look at you, you pull me back into your brain. swim a little deeper. I don't need to breathe. My main reason for fishing the inside is that I want some additional footage. I just don't want the fish to show up and take the bait immediately. So that's the main reason I'm fishing the inside.
I don't know the reasons. I'm not sure I really care. We're all over demons.
Well, that didn't work neither, but the problem was I couldn't see the bait from where I was standing. I changed it again and moved it so I really could see the corn.
Deep it goes. With my head underwater.